Hello guys, welcome to Bank AB channel. The Basel Accord II is the second set of international banking regulations defined by the Basel Committee on Banking Supervision. It is the extension of the regulation for minimum capital requirements as defined under Basel I. The Basel II comprises three pillars. Pillar 1, minimum capital requirements. Pillar 2, supervisory review. And Pillar 3, Market Discipline. Under Pillar 1, banks should determine the risk-weighted assets, RWA, using either standardized approaches or internal model-based approaches. This video comprises three parts. The first part is about minimum capital requirements. The second part is about the credit risk mitigants and also the credit risk mitigators. And the last part is about three categories of exposures. Minimum capital requirement. A percentage of financial institutions' primary capital to its assets, including loan and investment, used as a measurement of its financial strength and stability. According to capital adequacy standards by Bank for International Settlement, BIS, banks must have a primary capital base equal to at least 8% of their assets. A bank that lends $20 for every dollar of its capital is within a prescribed limit. Credit risk mitigants. Credit risk mitigants include three indicators. 1. Loss given default, or LGD. Loss given default refers to the amount of money a bank loses when a borrower defaults on a loan. 2. Exposure at default, or EAD. Exposure at default is a parameter used in the calculation of economic capital or regulatory capital under Basel II for a banking institution. 3. Possibility of default, or PD. Possibility of default refers to the likelihood that a borrower will fail to meet debt obligations within a specified time period over 1 year. Credit risk mitigators. Credit risk mitigators include three categories. 1. Collaterals. 2. Guarantees. And 3. Credit derivatives. Lenders use these three mitigators to minimize the risk of losing all of their original investment, including loan and debts, due to borrowers defaulting on their interest payment or principal payment. Banks, by obtaining guarantees or collaterals, reduce the default risk of their borrowers. Also, credit derivatives are financial contracts that allow banks to minimize their exposure to credit risk. Three categories of exposures. 1. Exposure secured by residential mortgages. These exposures include loans that are designed to help borrowers purchase a property which they live in. The property must be used as a residence by those taking out the mortgage. They are not able to rent out these properties or use the properties for commercial purposes. Two. Revolving unsecured exposures, such as credit cards. The exposures are revolving, unsecured, and uncommitted, both contractually and in practice. Revolving unsecured exposures are defined as those where the outstanding balances are permitted to fluctuate based on their decision to borrow and repay up to a limit established by a bank. Category of exposures are non-mortgage unsecured exposures, or retail exposures, to small business enterprises. These exposures are risky, since the value of security is usually less than 10% of the outstanding exposures.